rejoice. Sing to the Lord and rejoice, for He is to say. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the parish and national shrine of Saint Padre Pio. Today, the last day of April, we celebrate the memorial of Saint Pius V, Pope. Let us pray together with all our intentions. For those people who are entrusting themselves to our prayers, those who are celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries today, those who are continuously praying for healing and for all their intentions through Saint Padre Pio, and for the eternal repose of all our departed loved ones. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, To pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who in your providence raise up Pope Saint Pius V in your church, that the faith might be safeguarded and more fitting worship be offered to you, grant through his intercession that we may participate in your mysteries with lively faith and fruitful charity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of Apostles. In those days, some Jews from Antioch and Iconium arrived and won over the world. They stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, supposing that he was dead. But when the disciples gathered around him, he got up and entered the city. On the following day, he left with Barnabas for Derbe. After they had proclaimed the good news to the city and made a considerable number of disciples, they returned to Lystra and to Iconium and to Antioch. They strengthened the spirits of the disciples and exhorted them to persevere in the faith, saying, "It is necessary for us to undergo many hardships to enter the kingdom of God." They appointed presbyters for them in each church, and with prayer and fasting, commended them to the Lord, in whom they had put their faith. Then they traveled through Pisidia and reached Pamphylia. After proclaiming the words of Perga, they went down to Italia. From there, they sailed to Antioch, where they had been commended to the grace of God for the work they had now accomplished. And when they arrived, they called the church together and reported what God had done with them and how he had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. Then they spent a little time with the disciples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Respel Serial Sam. Your friend make you know, O Lord, a glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Let all your words give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
Your friend make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations.
Your friend make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
May my mouth speak the praise of the Lord, and may all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever.
Your friend make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled and afraid. You heard me tell you, I am going away and I will come back to you. If you loved me, you would rejoice that I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it happens, so that when it happens, you may believe. I will no longer speak much with you, for the ruler of the world is coming. He has no power over me. But the world must know that I love the Father, and that I do just as the Father has commanded me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Also, we want to pray for those who are joining us via live streaming, especially ang ating mga kababayan mula sa iba't ibang panig ng mundo. Jesus is telling us in the Gospel of today, the last day of April, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you." Jesus is offering us peace. The question is, if we know the difference of the peace that Christ is giving and offering to us with the peace that the world is giving us. Napakalaki po ng pagkakaiba ng kapayapaan na ibinibigay ni Kristo kaysa sa kapayapaan na ibinibigay ng mundong ito. we might be thinking na ang kapayapaang kailangan natin ay yung kapayapaang walang away, kapayapaang walang problema, kapayapaang masaya lamang lahat. Pero hindi po iyon ang sinasabi ni Jesus, sapagkat pwede kang maging mapayapa kahit meron kang pinagdadaanan. At doon po tayo makalalapit. Katulad po nating mga naririto, magkakaibang ating hinihingi. May iba sa ating humihingi ng kapanatagan, humihinging magkatrabaho, humihiling na gumaling, maging maayos sa pamilya. Pero pagkatapos naman ng misang ito, yung hinihingi ninyong at inaalala ninyong pambayad sa utang, utang nyo pa rin naman. Pag-uwi nyo mamaya, galit pa rin sa inyo inyong kapitbahay. Pagkatapos ng misang ito, pag-uwi ninyo, may problema pa rin naman kayo. That is the peace that Christ is offering to us. Ang kapayapaang dulot ni Kristo, yung alam mong panatag ang kalooban mo kahit sa gitna ng iyong problema. At ang kapayapaang iyon, manggagaling lamang sa Diyos. Hindi natin kailanman makakamtan sa mundong ito ang tunay na kapayapaan. O at minsan, makakaranas tayo ng kasiyahan, kasaganahan, yaman, ang lahat ng ito'y panandalian. Ngunit ang kapayapaang dulot ni Kristo, ito yung kahit may alalahanin ka, alam mong panatag ka dahil alam mong si Kristo ang bahala sa iyo. Ito yung kahit may iniintindi ka, ito yung kahit may iniisip ka, kaya mong matulog ng mapayapa mamayang gabi. Ito yung sa kabila ng iyong problema, kaya mong magpasalamat sa Diyos. Ito yung kapayapaang sa gitna ng ating kasalanan at mga pagkukulang, kaya nating lumapit muli sa Diyos. Yun ang kapayapaang ipinagkaiba ng kapayapaang dulot ni Kristo. At saan natin matatagpuan iyon? Tama po ang inyong pinuntahan. Ang kapayapaang dulot ni Kristo, makikita natin sa banal na Eukaristiya. Matatanggap natin sa banal na Misa. Sigurado tayo, pag-uwi mamaya, may problema pa rin. Pero makakamta natin ngayon ang kapayapaang sinasabi ni Kristo, ito yung kapayapaang siya ang bahala. Ito yung kapayapaang kahit may alalahanin, naroroon ang pag-asang makakamtan ang biyaya. Ito yung kapayapaang sa gitna ng maraming problema, alam mong malulutas din ito pagdating ng tamang panahon. Kaya nga po mga minamahal, in this Holy Mass, let us ask Jesus when we receive Him in the communion later, ibulong niyo po sa Kanya. Sabihin ninyo, Panginoon, bigyan mo po ako ng kapayapaang dulot mo, yung kapayapaang nanggagaling sa loob ng aking puso, yung kapayapaang magpapasigla sa akin sa kabila ng aking kahinaan, yung kapayapaang maninigurado na ikaw ang bahala sa gitna ng aking mga problema at pinagdadaanan sa buhay.
For your offering in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets.
Lord, we gather to thee. In your house, we kneel down and pray. We ask for your mercy. As we open our hearts to receive your forgiveness, O Lord. Lord, we lift up to you all these gifts we offer for your glory. We will eat this living bread, we will drink this saving cup and feel
please all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for your good and the good of all His holy church.
Accept this sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honor of blessed Pope Pius V, a means to our eternal salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Pope Pius V, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthened her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body and one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Pope Pius V, and with all the saints, we rely for unfailing help, on whose constant intercession and in your presence. May this sacrifice serve our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Gilbert our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your Son. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on all the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. of the world, grant us peace, grant us peace.
Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Ang second collection po ay para sa patuloy na pagpapaunlad ng parokya at pambansang dambana ni Santo Padre Pio at para sa pangangailangan ng matatanda at may sakit na paring ng Arsidiosis ng Lipang. Salamat po sa inyong handog. All stand.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which blessed Pope Pius V burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly for your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. prayer for intercession to Saint Padre Pio.
Padre Pio, holy monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon in this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage. With you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that we concede. Bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain, in God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the Most Holy, to instruct us in the gospel, that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit and Jesus the Mediator. Amen.
Please be seated.
Ilan lamang pong mga paalaala. Una, sa inyong pagbisita sa pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ng inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, sa paligid ng ating simbahan, may makikita kayong mga QR code. Pakiscan po at pakilagay ng ilang hinihinging detalye tulong sa ating documentation program at upang matulungan tayong makalap ang mga datos ng mga pilgrims at devotees na bumibisita dito. Asahan po ninyong sa pamamagitan ng Batas ng Data Privacy Act ng 2012, iingatan namin ang inyong mga private informations. Ang inyong tulong at suporta ay malaking bagay para sa pagtatagumpay ng proyektong ito. Do, unang Sabado ng buwan, tayo may pagpaparangal sa Mahal na Birhen ng mga biyaya. May prosesyon sa 5 ng umaga. Sa mga sasama, kayo po'y inaasahang magdala ng mga kandila. Maraming salamat sa inyo. Inaasahan namin inyong pananatilihin ng kalinisan, katahimikan at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating mga simbahan. We all stand for the blessing of the religious articles. O Lord our God, you are the source of all blessings and grace. Pour out your blessing on these instruments of prayer, the rosaries, images, prayer booklets, healing rub, and miracle oil that remind us of your goodness, holiness, and love to us, so that all who came and prayed through them may receive your mercy and grace. Through them, help the faithful imitate the holiness and teaching of the Lord and of the saints forever.
Amen. Ama namin, sumasalangit ka, sambahin ang ngalan mo, mapasamin ang kaharian mo, sundin ang loob mo dito sa lupa para ng sa langit. Bigyan mo kami ngayon ng aming kakanin sa araw-araw at patawarin mo kami sa aming mga sala para ng pagpapatawad namin sa nagkakasala sa amin. At huwag mo kami pahintulot sa tukso at iadya mo kami sa lahat na masama. Amen. Aba, Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoon Diyos ay suma sa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak si Jesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kami makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamatay. Amen. Aba, Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoon Diyos ay suma sa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak si Jesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kami makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamatay. Amen. Aba, Ginoong Maria, napupuno ka ng grasya. Ang Panginoon Diyos ay suma sa iyo. Bukod kang pinagpala sa babaeng lahat at pinagpala naman ang iyong anak si Jesus. Santa Maria, Ina ng Diyos, ipanalangin mo kami makasalanan ngayon at kung kami mamatay. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak, at sa Espiritu Santo, kaparunong sa una, ngayon, at magpakailanman, magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak, at sa Espiritu Santo, kaparunong ng una, ngayon, at magpakailanman, magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. Luwalhati sa Ama, sa Anak, at sa Espiritu Santo, kaparunong ng una, ngayon, at magpakailanman, magpasawalang hanggan. Amen.
We thank all our servers and all of you who participated in this Holy Mass. Thank you very much. You take care of yourself always. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. We go in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Heaven rejoice, for He is risen. Rise up, our Savior is He. Glory to God, proclaim His name, Jesus the Lord of